Hi, I just realized that I never made a short but detailed video about the splitting of the moon in the Islamic doctrine. So now it's my chance to expose the lies of Muhammad and his man-made Quran. Yes, you heard it correctly. It's time. Let's do this. Unfortunately, for the last 1400 years, many Muslims have fallen victim to the lies and deception, the makr and the taqiyya of Muslim shuyukh, imams, ustaz, the scholars of Islam, who have been lying to their audience, let's say inside mosques. Muslim shuyukh, Muslim scholars, have made a business out of lies and deception. And we know that more than 75% of the Islamic Ummah don't know Arabic. They have no idea what the secret, the hidden secret is behind the real meaning of the Quranic ayah that is talking about the splitting of the moon. So today we will uncover the secrets, and we are going to show you that the imams are nothing but liars. They are nothing but liars, like their fake prophet who proclaimed prophethood 1400 years ago. So if you are a sincere Muslim and you are a truly seeker of truth, then continue listening. If you are a Muslim who doesn't care about the truth, please don't forget to give me a dislike. If you are a Christian or an atheist, give me a like. So let us actually start. It is the very famous ayah from chapter 54, Al-Qamar, ayah 1. Iqtarabat as-sa'atu wa inshaqqa al-qamar. The last hour came near and the moon split apart. I mean, you don't have to be a genius to understand that this is talking about the end of times, about the last day, the last hour, judgment day. It did not happen 1400 years ago. It didn't happen 1 hour ago. It didn't happen 2 seconds ago. No, this is talking about future events when judgment day will happen. Then, and only then, the moon will be split apart. Now, let us see what actual scholars of Islam, old school scholars, the crème de la crème, people like Al-Tabari, has to say about this ayah in their tafsir. So let us go to Al-Tabari, who is considered to be the number one Islamic scholar, mufassir, someone who is giving his commentary on the ayahs of the Quran. And who is better to go to than Al-Tabari himself? So let us do that. يقول الطبري في تفسيره لاقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. In his tafsir, Al-Tabari says, for the hour is near and the moon has split, the following. يعني تعالى ذكره بقوله اقتربت الساعة. دانت الساعة التي تقوم فيها القيامة وقوله اقتربت افتعلت من القرب وهذا من الله تعالى ذكره انذار لعباده بدنو القيامة وقرب فناء الدنيا وقوله وانشق القمر يقول جل ثناؤه وانفلق القمر وكان ذلك فيما ذكر على عهد رسول الله وهو بمكة قبل هجرته إلى المدينة وذلك أن الكفار أهل مكة سألوه آية فأراهم صلى الله عليه وسلم انشقاق القمر آية حجة على صدق قوله وحقيقة نبوته فلما أراهم أعرضوا وكذبوه. This was تفسير الطبري for chapter 54 آية 1 سورة القمر آية 1. Unfortunately, I don't have it in English, but I will try to give you a small summary in a nutshell what is said in the tafsir of At-Tabari. Now, this tafsir for chapter 54, ayah 1 from Al-Tabari, it starts talking about Danat al-Sa'a allati taqum fiha al-Qiyamah. That means and the hour is near, so the hour is near now, and that means that the day of resurrection, Al-Qiyamah means resurrection, so it's talking about the judgment day. So here At-Tabari is saying that when the moon is going to split, that means it's judgment day. It's the day of resurrection, where all people are going to be resurrected and judged by God. In this case, Allah, the Islamic Allah. And if we continue reading, in a nutshell, we continue reading, the people of Mecca, Al-Kuffar, they started to ask Ahl Mecca, they started to ask Muhammad, show us a sign, give us a sign, right? And he did that to prove his prophethood. So here Muhammad proved his prophethood by giving him, by giving them the ayah. So he showed them the ayah by splitting the moon. And when they saw it happen, they started to reject him and call him a liar. But wait a second. I mean, we need to understand this very important thing. We will not allow Muslims to go away with this incident very easily. Because why would the kuffar of Mecca, right, the unbelievers of Mecca, the pagans of Mecca, why would they reject Muhammad if they see with their own eyes the moon being split? I mean, if they really saw it with their own eyes, they would have bowed down, started to prostrate Allah, and immediately recite the Shahada. So no, instead, they rejected him and they called him a liar. Who? They called Muhammad a liar. They rejected him. Why would they do that? Because this is nonsense. You see, Muslims started to even force nonsense, lies, taqiyya and deception inside even tafsir. Do you see it? And this is the creme de la creme, right? Al-Tabari himself, his tafsir for this ayah of the Quran. So now we are noticing, now we are starting to noticing something, which is here At-Tabari is basically quoting what Sahih al-Bukhari is saying in the hadith. The hadith is saying that Muhammad made the moon split in half, right? When they asked him for a sign. But why would they reject him? Why would the kuffar, why would the unbelievers reject him if he truly showed him a sign, showed them a sign by splitting the moon in half? They should actually bow down, do sujood to Allah, prostrate to Allah and recite the Shahada and become Muslims. So there's a fishy thing going on here, don't you think? You can be the judge of that. Do you see how they later, the Muslims themselves, much later, started to even corrupt the tafsir? Because you cannot say or force me to believe that first the tafsir starts with, this is talking about the day of resurrection, the day of judgment, and later the tafsir is contradicting itself, and Muhammad giving a sign, splitting the moon, and we see the unbelievers of Mecca rejecting him and calling him a liar. That doesn't make sense. Here we have a 100% contradiction, and this proves that even in the tafsir we see contradictions much later adding on top what was already said. So not only the Quran is corrupted by Muslim hands, but even the tafsir, even the hadith. So basically, in a nutshell, Muslims much later, when the hadith came into existence, let's say Sahih al-Bukhari was written down by Imam al-Bukhari after him collecting all the hadith and separating falsehood, so-called falsehood, from his collection, and then later it's called Sahih al-Bukhari, the collection of Sahih al-Bukhari, as it is. You see how Muslims tried to make Muhammad look like a real prophet, forcing ayahs, right? Signs, forcing signs
into his prophethood.
While the Quran is clear, crystal clear, we refrain from giving signs. Allah said in the Quran, we refrain from sending down signs because the people that came later rejected it. So Allah is clear. We refrain from sending down ayahs or signs. So there are no signs given or sent down to Muhammad or given to Muhammad. Only the Quran, and you have many scholars who confirm it and agree on it. Only the Quran is a sign from Allah, a miracle from Allah. Miracles or signs were not given to Muhammad. So when you're going to say as a Muslim, Muhammad made miracles, you are lying because you are contradicting the Quran, exactly what we find in Tafsir al-Tabari and in hadith like Sahih al-Bukhari. Do you see it? Now you understand what is happening, right guys? And by the way,
if Florian didn't say so, that means it is so.
I want to share a piece of a clip with you, which is from this individual called Farid. I went to his video in which he's trying to refute my moon splitting, and look what I found. Look what his argument is.
You would expect that the Persians and the Romans, in this time the Byzantines, would document such a miracle, because both of them, especially the Romans, kept records strictly of pretty much everything.
There's another issue with Ridwan's assumption here. One of the reasons why we do not have heaps of documented evidence was because most people were asleep at night. Remember, this is the 7th century.
The argument here is we don't have any secondary reports of the moon splitting in two in the 7th century because it happened at night, because people were sleeping. You know, people were sleeping. They didn't see that because, you know, people were asleep.
Because most people were asleep at night.
Am I the only one who thinks this is the most, one of the most ridiculous things that I've ever heard?
He's got a point. Most people would be asleep. I mean, come on, you can't deny that. People sleep at night. Come on.
You are so silly.
Alhamdulillah for Islam, brada. Please recite the Shahada, brada, and you will get 72 male virgins with big breast, brada. Alhamdulillah, subhanallah, brother. Muhammad told the truth in his Quran, brother. Are you going to accept my da'wah to Islam? I'm sure you're going to do that. You will recite the Shahada, brother, today.